Kanya Mabaki Jibawo. Wenyama Nandi Kanya Mabaki Jibawo.
From the day we arrived, planning, there's more to gain.
The circle of life, and it moves us on. The circle of life.
Very special. Welcome to our new members and our new friends. This, our 33rd annual International Summit. Thank you very much. Now, we'll have a welcome from our chairman emeritus, Mr. Dean White.
To be here in colorful, wonderful, and gracious and receptive Kenya. A few years ago, we met Susan in Sapporo, Japan, and she opened new doors for all of us. I've traveled to Kenya and to Nairobi many times, staying at the famous Fairmont Norfolk Hotel, and it's a treat to be back. I know all of you will enjoy these next 2 days as you have the earlier part of the journey, and to welcome so many new wonderful faces. You're all very special to us, and we're delighted that you have come. Thank you and enjoy.
And now from our special hostess, Mrs. Susan Murithi from the Suera Flower Farm. Susan invited us originally in Japan 3 years ago to come to Kenya. And after all this time and all this planning, that dream has come true. Susan, will you welcome us, please?
Jambo. Very good. It is my pleasure, Mr. Chairman, Chairman Emeritus, and to all of you, and thank you so much for agreeing to come to visit our country and to show us how you do it in your part of the world. You are very, very welcome. Thank you, and God bless you. Asante sana.
He's the deputy CEO and the principal auditor of the Kenya Flower Council. We could not have done this without our co-sponsors, the Kenya Flower Council. They have been so generous in providing the product that we need and all the support. John, please.
On behalf of the Chief Executive Officer, Jane Gige, who is currently coming from the Brussels, Europe, she will be here later in the day. I would want to say Karibu Kenya. Karibu Kenya. We at the Kenya Flower Council work with the flower growers and exporters. We have a lot of flowers, roses. So many flowers are grown from Kenya and exported to you. And we are grateful that you continue using these flowers. Thank you very much. And we say Karibu Kenya. Kenya is a country of 42 ethnic groups. We have beautiful beaches. We have the big five, the animals, and very hospitable people. So feel at home. We welcome you.
We are ready to start our program. We're excited to have the Kenya Floral Arrangement Club to present our first presentation of the day, Dreaming of Africa.
Welcome to Kenya. On behalf of the Kenya Floral Arrangement Club, I welcome you to today's demonstration, Dreaming of Africa. Welcome. We are now taking a journey to Mount Kenya, and I will now hand over to my beautiful friend in flowers, Mrs. Pramila Lada, to take us to the journey of Mount Kenya.
Mount Kenya is the second highest in Kenya, first highest in the Kenya and second highest in Africa. So it is difficult to walk away from the side. The base of Mount Kenya, we have a lot of spaces there. Especially the alpine forest. I present to you the valleys, slopes, and beautiful peak of the mountain. Now I hand over to my friend Nimita Shah.
Our journey, beautiful, isn't it? Our journey now takes us to our journey takes us to the Great Rift Valley now. I'd just like to talk about the Great Rift Valley, how it was formed. The Great Rift Valley was formed by violent subterranean forces. These forces caused the crust to sink between parallel fault lines and forced up molten rock.
Thank you, Priya. Good morning, friends. Karibu Kenya, and I welcome you to the continent of Africa.
Today, we take you in the journey to see Egypt. The most fundamental is water. Without water, there is no life. And without the River Nile, there is no Egypt. So I'm going to present to you one of the tributaries of the Nile. River Nile is the world's largest river, which its source in Burundi. And it flows through many different countries of Africa northwards into the Mediterranean Sea. We can also enjoy some of the Egyptian music which is being played by one of our musicians there. Thank you very much. I'm putting in some palm strings to present to you some of the flow of the water. That's my tributary of the Nile. Now I take you to see the ancient. I take you to see the Egyptian mummies. Having visited Egypt, it's not complete if you have not seen the pyramids and the mummies. The Egyptian pharaohs, in the olden times, the Egyptians believed in life after death. So for them, it was very important. After death, they used to tie the Egyptian body in a linen cloth
I put a very little piece of linen cloth here, but they used to actually wrap the whole body with the linen cloth very tightly to preserve their pharaohs. And then these pharaohs were buried in tombs. Death, and in the next life, the Egyptians will get the best. Their pharaohs will have the best life in the second life. Egyptian cotton is one of the world's best cotton.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Our next demonstrator today for Kenya Floral Arrangement Club and a very hard-working secretary too. So enjoy the demonstration from Pritesh.
Many of you will have been allured by the white sandy beaches and the azure waters, but there is a lot more than meets the eye, as a Swahili coastal narrative will depict. Begins in the depth of time. Dhows from mystical and ancient lands, Persia, India, China, and other islands sailed across the Indian Ocean. These dhows had very strong masts made out of coconut palm trunks to withstand the gales and forces of nature along their turbulent journey across the Indian Ocean. Important feature of our Swahili culture and coastal history is the trade, the Indian Ocean trade, which was so the bartering of so many commodities. Some of the commodities which were exported from the dark interior of the continent of Africa were skins and hide of wildlife. Of course, with their velvety texture, what better than Kalenko Beharensis to depict the fabulous skins and hides? I present to you the monsoon trade. The Swahili culture was a fusion culture, and with it came many interesting aspects of life. These type of wood carvings are a very unique feature of Swahili architecture. And of course, the cotton cloth, hanga, all of them are emblazoned with a unique proverb to remind the wearer of the facets of everyday life. Our coastal gardens are very lush and tropical. Heliconias, fruits from various palms, crotons abound in these paradise islands. To us, a glimpse of tribal Africa. So please put your hands together for Aruna Shah.
Thank you. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Jambo, Rafiki Zetu. It's a Kenyan greeting. The African culture is very wide and varied, with many tribes all over Africa. North Africa and West Africa have different tribes and culture compared to East and South Africa. In my design, I have used calabashes, which are more used in Kenya and East Africa. These calabashes are very versatile. These are the vessels they use for drinking, because the plastics are no more used with the tribes. They use these ones, they're very eco-friendly. is the fawn from the Valencia, the white one. So this is the design I'm presenting to you, the rich culture of Maasai people. I'm going to explain you about this design. This is the dance of Maasai, is one of the cultures of most tribes and very popular. I have used these yucca leaves to depict the dance costume of the Africans. Normally they wear the sisal one, but I have depicted it with the yucca, dried yucca leaves. Because they love the beautiful colors, they are very fond of bright colors. That's why I have used the strelitzia leaves. And the bows and arrows and straws they take with them to protect them from the wild animals wherever they are, because there are lots of wild animals around. Heads have gone a bit that way, but I think that's the gravity, isn't it? That's the gravity force, tension. Yeah? So this is my presentation of the culture of Africa.
Hope all of you are enjoying this beautiful artistic demonstration by Kenya Floral Arrangement Club. I am Praveena Shah. I am currently the treasurer of Kenya Floral Club. I keep the money properly. I'm also a floral judge and a demonstrator. This is my co-demonstrator, Harshida Shah. The agriculture productivity of Kenya, which is mostly grown in Western Kenya, and most of the sugar cane is used for production of sugar, which is used locally.
So I've done my baskets with fruits, the vegetables, all which are grown locally for export and for local market. Corn is a very staple food for African and local people here. That is my vegetable basket. So.
We have used baskets and pots in our design to bring the culture of Africa. And baskets are used to carry vegetables and granny bags to carry vegetables and cereals to transport most of the time in Kenya. I've used agao, dry agao, that represents sisal made from agao. So there is a local market for sisal to tie up all the vegetables together. Beautiful liliums, which is the grown in Naivasha, Lake Naivasha. They are also grown in other parts of Kenya, like Nakuru, Kitale, Nanyuki. I've got sunflower, which is grown for commercial use, and they get seeds, and then we get they extract oil from sunflower, and it's a big market in Kenya. It's exported to Africa. Many of the African countries. Beautiful calla lilies. They are local produce from the surrounding areas. And most of the roses are for export to European market. Sample Africa. My lilies placement. Thank you.
I put this seed heads there from Mombasa to give that rhythm in the design. Coffee and tea are the third largest foreign exchange for Kenya.
So I think we do a lot of exporting and locally used products we have used here today.
That's our production, agricultural products of Kenya.
I now take privilege in introducing our last but not the least demonstrator for this morning, Viba Dodia, who is the president of Kenya Floral Arrangement Club, an active judge, demonstrator, and also very active in the Lions organization. She will leave us with a tantalizing glimpse of what we hope will not be your farewell for this morning, sunsets of gold and fire.
Good morning, everybody. Pritesh, thank you very much for a brilliant introduction. And now I take you to a beautiful sunset in Kenya and Africa. I have some groundwork ready in my arrangement, a dry cactus just to cover my big metal mechanics, and pieces of driftwood going horizontally, and then these are a kind of dry cactus. And to depict the rays of the sun, I am using this orange anthuriums and making it look like as if they're growing out from the sun. Hope people traveling on Monday for their tours will have a chance to see it. I'll just put it together properly. Now, this is my sunset, and this is a reason why seeing a spectacular sunset should be everyone's bucket list to experience. And I want to read a famous quote which says, "Africa, you can see a sunset and believe you have witnessed hand of God." This is my sunset. Thank you.
Up and dust yourself off and back in the saddle. You're on the front line. Everyone's keep looking up. Tamina, mina, sangalewa. Cause this is Africa. Tamina, mina, waka, waka, Tamina, mina, sangalewa. This time for Africa.
I think we are quite excited to have such a nice audience, a big group, and quite a new audience as well.
Yes, we have a lot of new friends and we have a lot of new members. So welcome to our country design session. This is a really a very special and unique program for World Flower Council.
Yes, because all the participating countries that are here, and that is 16 at this event, are going to present their country design.
Mr. Anson Low, AIFD from Singapore.
Jumbo.
Jumbo.
And today I'll present something from the wire and some of the branches or anything that you can bend it to create a nice sculpture.
Very nice material, good colors that you chose. So we'll wait and see what you're going to
do.
Yes,
as he mentioned, he comes from a country which is a lot of modern architectures. So very, very structural design that Mr. Low Anson is doing. And I really enjoy to see his kind of masculine design and ideas all the time. So we will wait and see. Next designer we have Ufi from, can I call you just that?
Yes.
Okay, Ufi from Pakistan.
Yes. Khush Ahmadid from Pakistan. And the design that we have chosen to make for this occasion is a beautiful place in Pakistan called Shangri-La. Shangri-La is a part of paradise. And you have the Tibetan, the Buddhist, and the Chinese influence in this area of Pakistan.
I really admiring your branches. Can you?
Thank you.
Is that are you bringing along with?
Yes,
are you brought
we brought
with you?
Them. We brought them from Pakistan. We brought the stand from Pakistan, and when we complete the design, I'll tell you a little more about
okay.
it.
Okay. Okay. So the stand and the branches are from Pakistan. She brought along with her, and I can see that it's a very clever mechanic where we can put the floral foam for the flowers. And the color that you choose is very monochromatic.
Well, the next designer
Oh, yeah.
Here from South Korea.
Yeah.
You already explained me a few things about your design, so
okay.
Welcome.
안녕하십니까. 저는 한국에서 온 이민숙이라고 합니다.
Hello, everyone. My name is Lee Min-suk. I'm from Korea, South Korea. This work is a design of a bouquet show.
케이블 타이어를 둥글게 둥글게 이어가면서.
In overall design, cable tie connected in a round shape for rhythm and movement.
Yeah.
Tell us a little bit more about your design.
Greetings to all from St. Kitts and Nevis. I am Jovil Rogers and I have with me Gary Thompson. Our design is inspired by the work of our country's first national hero, Sir Robert Llewellyn Bradshaw. He was a gentleman who worked in the sugar industry in St. Kitts, and he inspired the workers. He was very concerned with the awful treatment that the workers were experiencing, and he decided to devote his life towards the upliftment of the workers in the sugarcane industry. Now, we started our design by using large leaves, the base of the arrangement, using very large green leaves that are grown in the lower hills on our island, under Mount Liamiga. And we use red anthuriums to show a circle of love, embracing the people and encouraging them to continue to struggle. As the people continued struggling upwards, they were inspired by the sunlight. We used the yellow daisies to form a circle of love again to inspire the workers to continue climbing towards freedom and to continue climbing towards prosperity. We used the baby's breath here to continue the circle of love and encouragement, and also the clouds as they are climbing upwards on the ladder to feel a sense of hope and motivation as they continue to grow upwards. And that's our presentation today. Thank you.
I think your explanation is really beautiful, and to take a national hero from your island to represent that in this country show makes it very special.
Now I want to show you the tension, the movements, the power of Singapore. Ooh. For the whole idea is how you enjoy doing things that it always move, change, and don't really stay on the same place. Just turn it upside down. Move to the wall. You know, you create something that is even you don't expect the design. Thank you.
I always admiring his work because Anson is a very fantasized designers who always dream big, and you can see that the space and the light is very dominant in this design. I would call it a very, very oriental elements that we never forget about the lights and the space, and the flow, the movement, the space, and the form. It's just abstract and incredible.
Okay, I don't cut. but I don't know why they
But just now you cut.
This is streaming.
To combine orange with burgundy red, it's so attractive and so new that you can see the result of those colors together.
Shangri-La is a very popular tourist destination in Pakistan. The author narrates a plane crash in this area in the early 1920s. The surviving passengers came across some Buddhist monks. The Buddhists were very young looking. The effect of this area on the human beings is it keeps you young. It's eternal youth in this area, so they claim. This heavenly place was then called Shangri-La, a Tibetan word meaning paradise on earth.
Her construction is really beautiful because when you see the black frame, it's flat. But then she made it three-dimensional by placing the black wood to make the arrangement even more three-dimensional. So the cymbidiums that are in the glass tubes, they are really a very nice size to balance out the weight of the arrangements, of the two horizontal arrangements. It's very clever how she placed those. Because again, there's a lot of tension the way she divided them through those two frames.
We come to South Korea. Yeah. I from far, I really enjoy seeing the very transparency constructions.
한국의 태극기의 의미입니다.
I finish my presentation here and wish all WFC members to carry on living in harmony and loving one another. Thank you.
For this design from Korea, I have a little secret to tell you. She brought all her flowers from Korea. I don't know how she get in, but it's thank you.
Yeah,
all the flowers from Korea. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, from St. Kitts, we present the Fountain of Hope.
Very good. Thank you so much.
Adding flowers,
yes.
I can see now beautiful calathea leaf.
When you come to Kenya, if you don't use roses,
you are not here yet.
It's not here yet. So the number of flowers that you use must be the right number. So I use three. It means I love you. Thank Whoa. You.
Big round of applause for all the designers, please. Mr. Anson Low, AIFD from Singapore.